Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to get into if Drake made a diss, how would it go? So what I'm going to do is record my own vocal. We're going to transform that vocal into like a background element in the song. And then we're going to add a vocal take in the mind of Drake that rhymed. And we're going to add the beat underneath it. So let me start with my random vocal ideas, like, you know, things like that. Let me tap the tempo. So we're at about 97 BPM. Let's make sure we turn our metronome on, because when you record raw vocal ideas, you want to make sure you're measuring how long you're singing. It's easier to sample yourself when you measure. So let's turn that metronome on. That's important. Whoops. Let's go to our mixer. Let's grab our mic track. We're going to make sure we're arming disc for recording. I'm going to go back to stop. And I'm just going to record different random ideas that I have. It doesn't have to be anything solid, but I'm thinking of these ideas as something in the background. So let's go to record audio into playlist as an audio clip. Let me toss on my headphones and let me turn down headphones. So I'm going to turn down my headphone response so I don't hear myself too much, because that can throw me off. Let me turn off the input. There we go. Okay, so now let's do this one more time. Record. A lot of people ask, just a side note, they say that their microphones are delayed. If you look in the mixer here, I'm talking on track one. There is a routing situation from track one to the master. If you look at the bottom left, if I left click this, that will silence the feedback that you're hearing. So that's how you hear yourself and monitor. So just left click that off. Okay, so now I'm not going to hear myself through the track as much. So let's hit record. Audio into playlist. Let me think of something else. Let me see.
Breathe fire. Homeless.
Just gibberish.
Breathe. Homeless pie. Yeah. Breeze fire. Homeless vibe. Brothers ready, reach fire. Homeless pie.
So I just randomly said random words. I mean, it could be reach for ya, but I'm just literally talking gibberish. You don't have to make this identifiable lyric. What we're going to do is manipulate it in part two. But the important part is that you recorded it. So now let's get into manipulating this through pitch, different effects, different things to kind of push it to the background. Now, one thing I like to do with vocals is transpose it into the other gender. So right now, this is a male vocal. I'm not going to transpose it into the female gender, but I usually like to using format filters. But let's pull this pitch down for the vocal take. So just a quick recap. So I'm not, you know, aiming for a different key. I'm not using auto-tune. You could add those effects if you want. I'm just going to pull down the pitch 400 cents at a time just to hear what it sounds like. I'm not going to use that one specifically.
Let me think of something else. Let me see.
Let me think of something else. So I like that one here. I'm going to get rid of everything in the beginning, and I'm just going to use that chop, reach fire, and it's just going to be in the background. Now I need something to kind of wrap it up. So I'm going to use that.
Just gibberish.
I'm going to use that take as just a secondary alternative. I'm going to change my snap to grid to none so I can just left click and slide that over a bit more to have that first syllable coming in clear.
Homeless vibe.
And I can use that as well.
Yeah.
So I need that, yeah, you know.
Reach vibe.
So I like those three takes. So we have the reach vibe, bum, 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 bum. So I'm going to use those as if they were instruments. Let me go in. Let's go to snap to grid none just so I can isolate each of these. Let's go to the slice tool. It's going to cut, whoops. Let's hit Control Z. I'm going to hit hold shift, left click and drag so I can cut right before the vocal. So we have those pieces to move around freely. And I'm going to slice this here.
Breathe fire.
So I can actually use it in this. I'm just going to make sure it's lining up with the grid. So it's lining up so far. We have 8 bars. Let's run this through Fruity Delay 2, just with a ping pong delay set to full pan width, and then we're going to lower the time to 2. Let's turn down the input volume. Let's go to reverb. Let's open up Fruity Reverb 2. Give it a nice long decay time and a little pre-delay so it doesn't kick in for a while. Turn down the wet level. And you can actually turn down the dry level if you want to make it blurrier. But that kind of takes away from some of the aspects. What I'm going to do is add a filter before all this with an EQ too. Just add a low pass filter with a little resonance. I'm going to find the frequency I like and boost that with the bandwidth tab here. I like it around 2K. That's a pretty good spot. Let's turn down the wet level a bit for the reverb. They can also transpose it into the female octaves. Let's try plus 400. It's going to sound a little fake, though. Sounds pretty good, transposed. That actually sounds pretty good. I'm actually going to use that. So that just happened to turn out well. Now there's a little pitch incorrectness. So I'm going to add a fruity chorus, kind of blur it together. So now let's build a track around this. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's load up some drums from the Ultimate Producer Bundle. Actually, let's go to the X drum kit. Let's load up the kicks. Let's find a kick that matches this kind of vibe. I think kick EO, more of an 808 kick, but let's right click, go to edit. Let's go to mark the pitch regions, detect pitch, the marker tab, go to detect pitch regions. This will give us the key of the 808. It's roughly at F sharp. I look at the longer frequency, not the transient frequency, because they can be different, especially with kicks and 808s. Let's go to our envelope. Let's right click on, what was it, F sharp. Okay, that's another reason why some people don't label their 808s, because you can be playing two different pitches in one 808. So I'm going to use this as our main kick, and let's find a snare. So snare RR. Let's start with the snare first. Let's right click our pattern icon, go to pattern 1. Let's pitch the snare. Right now it's too high pitched. Let's add reverb to the snare. Fruity Reverb 2. Let's give it a little wet level. Let's give it a little pre-delay so it doesn't come in right away. Let's add our kick. I'm going to start with the rhythm, then we're going to give it notation. Give it the right notation. I'm going to go D sharp. So let's pull that up to D sharp. I'm going to pull this down an octave. So I'm going to hit control down. Now we need to give it some type of instrumentation. I'm not going to use any hi-hats. Let's go to, let's see. Maybe we can use silent, doesn't matter. Let's go to menu, initialize preset. Start with the sine wave first. Let's do 4 voices and detune them all. Thank you. So I was thinking of lead options, but let's do a pad instead. First, let's keep the pad basic, just a sine wave. Then we can change it as we go. So I'm trying to figure out the chord. It might be a C major chord or C minor. Let's pull this up. It's going to be C minor. Let's add that. Let's pull this down an octave. So very basic chord, but I'm going to show you a quick way to change it up. So what I'm going to do here is expand the C major chord into the ninth version or the seventh version. It doesn't matter. You can learn more at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory about the terms I just used. In short, I'm going to add the notes B and then D, and I'm going to see which one sounds better transposed. So I'm going to grab the B note, and I know that's probably not going to sound good because we're going to have it close to C. But what I can do here is pull that down an octave and get rid of the root note. Adds a cool change up. So let's just continue that chord progression. Let's go back to C minor, and then we're going to do D instead. Pull that down an octave, but I'm going to keep the root note C. That doesn't sound good in the bass. So what I might do is change out D sharp for the note D, just to hear what this would sound like. And that adds tension, okay, to the chord progression. You can learn a lot more about the terms I'm talking about at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Let's increase the attack a bit and release so we have more of a pad D type of sound. I'm going to add two more sine voices at a lower octave, but I'm going to lower the volume tremendously so it doesn't get too muddy. I'm going to add an LFO to the volume just to make it change up over time, just slightly. The rate, I'm going to turn it on free mode and vary. Can't even tell the volume's going up and down. But those small little changes add up. Now let's add the famous Drake bass, which is a Moog type of bass. So let's open up Silent One. Let's go to menu, initialize preset. We're gonna do an 8-voice saw, detune it slightly or right below mid-level. We're gonna pull it down 2 octaves and add a low pass filter and turn that filter cutoff down and turn your resonance up. And we're gonna add portamento and monophonic mode. Okay, you can add distortion if you'd like, but that's basically the Drake bass. So all I'm going to do here is copy the root note or the bottom notes of our chord progression just to keep it simple. So let's copy those notes. Let's move into pattern 3. Let's right click into our new bass. Let's hit Control V to paste the piano roll MIDI into it. And now we have a bass element and we can layer that with our pad. Let me open up the filter a bit more for the bass. Turn my portamento on S or slide mode so that it always pitch bends because I don't have overlapping notes, so it won't pitch bend unless you have overlapping notes on normal mode, but on slide mode it slides regardless. Now this adds another tone to the track. Adds a little bit of a haunted mood. I'm gonna add a filter to the vocals. Let's copy that value. Let's pull our low pass down a bit. Give it more of that Drake vibe with the low pass filter. That's really it. After this, it's just arrangements, vocal ideas, and I'll add my vocal idea in the video. Thank you. softer energy diss track, you can go deep with the lyric because of the moods and the chord progression. So you can learn how to actually generate a mood using chord progression. That's what we teach at busyworksbeats.com/chordmagic. You can actually manipulate the environment or the mood of the track. So again, I'm going to do a freestyle verse to this, but you can take your time with your songwriting ideas. Notice how I have no cymbals, no hi-hats. So let's turn off the monitors and then we're going to do the vocal take. So let's add the vocal idea. Again, it could be gibberish, it could be a freestyle, you could write it, whatever you want to do. You want to add a vocal in the mind of the artist over the track. Okay, so let's get into that in the second half. Now let's add the vocal idea to the track just to bring it alive, just to show you how far you can take your beats and your song ideas. And you can go back and edit things as you add your vocal idea so that you can see where you need to enhance things. And this is a great exercise you want to do. Just add a vocal take in the mind of the artist. If you can't sing, it's fine. You can hum, you can whistle, you can beatbox. You could just talk gibberish. It doesn't have to be, you know, in a language. It's just, how are you going to approach the songwriting aspect? So now let's get into that. Let's go to our mixer. Okay, let's arm the track for recording. Let's drop this down. Let's go to our playlist. Let's hit record. Audio into playlist. I'm going to use these rhyme words as a cheat sheet so I don't just talk gibberish the whole time. Okay.
OVO steady on the billboard. I get the position they'd kill for. I am at the top and I'm still bored. If they want to run your boy, catch a steel force. Man, need me these days. Talking, writing books, talking each page. Yeah, I'm getting paid three ways. Try to kill me, I came up 3 days. What you know about me, catching sweepstakes. Man, I catch my own wave, that's a heat wave. And these other motherfuckers can't see Drake. Hotline bling, and it's prepaid. The rap game ain't in need Drake. I don't even know why they on the knees pray. Man, it's over your God in the sixth play. And I came up from the grind in the sixth grade. And I paid my mother's rent, I was 17. I ain't even have a Benz, I was 17. I was trying to act again, I was 17. Trying pulling up a brick that a 17. Pablo on the phone, now I got Jay-Z in my home. Now I got everybody in my zone. Now we mastermind in that throne. Now I'm good. OVO in your hood. All we know is do good. Shouts out to my body bag and my body bag and my hood. OVO was good. Toronto was good. Body these, cause they ain't ready for me. They ain't ready for me, nah.
So that was just a random vocal. Okay, I kind of freestyled cause I forgot the right rhyme words, but it came out pretty decent.
OVO steady on the billboard. I get the position they'd kill for. I am at the top and I'm still bored. If they wanna run your boy, catch a steel force. Man, need me these days. Talking, writing books, talking each page. Yeah, I'm getting paid.
Let me turn the vocal up a bit, just by.
OVO steady on the bill. OVO steady on the billboard. I get the position they'd kill for. I am at the top and I'm still bored. If they wanna run your boy, catch a steel force. Man, need me these days. talking writing books, talking each page. Yeah, I'm getting paid three ways. Try to kill me, I came up 3 days. What you know about me, catching sweepstakes. Man, I catch my own wave, that's a heat wave. And these other motherfuckers can't see Drake. Hotline bling, and it's prepaid. The rap game ain't in need Drake. I don't even know why they on the knees pray. Man, it's over yo, God in the sixth play. And I came up from the grind in the sixth grade. And I paid my mother's rent, I was 17. I ain't even have a Benz, I was 17. I was trying to act again, I was 17. Trying pulling up a brick that a 17. Pablo on the phone now, got Jay-Z in my home now, got everybody in my zone now, we mastermind in that throne now. I'm good, OVO in your hood, all we know is do good. Shouts out to my body bag and my body bag and my hood. OVO was good, Toronto was good. Body these, cause they ain't ready for me. They ain't ready for me, nah.
Okay, so that's what you want to do, just to understand the beat. So the beat sounds good with the vocal on it. You don't really need to do much except add some vocal things to the processing chain to make the vocal stick out. We'll do that for premium members, show you how to mix the vocal inside the track. And that wraps it up. So that was pretty quick, but that's what you want to do every track.